teed up for this, and what a start.
What a shot.
The red is not easy if he plays it. He'll avoid... He didn't want to hit it too thick and go into the bunch. He certainly didn't hit it too thick, did he?
The first chance of sorts. This isn't a gimme, but...
Your effort doesn't guarantee success. But it helps.
Which took him past Stephen Hendry with a record tally of the so-called Triple Crown events. Very motivated.
Yes, yesterday, in fact, was the 28th anniversary of that final. More sessions over a couple of days. But it was... Shoulders with the greats, isn't he? And he's very good himself. It's interesting watching him, just seeing.
In about half an hour, Auger eventually came back to win the decider. There you go.
44.
Just above it, he's now in play. The point where he's turning it into a frame-winning break, perhaps.
48.
And that's what break build is all about, it's positional.
56.
Would suffice to leave King needing a snooker, and another red 60. Thereafter would surely finish the frame.
Yes, and the bad news for Mark King, and it's only one frame, is that Ronnie O'Sullivan looks completely focused.
70.
Tickle into the four reds. Well, not the perfect. He's off and running, isn't he, the Rocket?
77.
Given their rivalry and the fact that inevitably there's a little bit of one-upmanship, a different stratosphere in terms of talent, but...
93.
That hasn't prevented King from being... So you can be sure that the Rocket will be keyed up.
101.
To call it, but a bit of vintage O'Sullivan here.
Vaulted frame initially. It was worth the wait. The yellow eludes him, but that's a superb start. UK champion. A break of 108 and a 1-0 lead.